What's up, guys? An Average Origamist here, and in this video, I'm going to be teaching you how to make the Fiddler Crab. So let me just show you this thing really quick. This is awesome. It is a crab. It has 8 legs, a big claw, and a small claw, and it takes a while to make. This was my very first try. You see, like, the back, you see the back ripped a little bit. Here's the bottom. It's awesome. This is easily going to be my hardest, my most challenging tutorial yet, but it's definitely worth it. Definitely worth it. I would recommend paper that is big, at least 25 centimeters, preferably bigger. For your first try, that is. This is it, guys. So let's make it. Here we go. Hopefully, it's gonna turn out. The one we make in the tutorial will turn out nicer than the one I just showed you. I'm sure it will. I mean, because now I know all the steps. So let's go. Color set up. Let's start with the diagonals. Both ways, obviously. Right. For these first couple steps, maybe like the first 20 to 30 steps, it's really important to keep the orientation of the paper correct. So you'll see what I mean soon. Okay, first step, well, the first real step, make a reference crease at the halfway point on this side. So only crease it a little bit. Like that. All right, and now make another reference crease from this corner to the halfway point. To the halfway point, to the crease we just made. Again, this is just a reference crease, so we'll just crease it a little bit. Okay, now we are going to make another reference crease. So the crease is going to be on this line, and it's going to be from this corner to here. So it's going to look something like this. Just like that. You need to press down the paper enough to know that it's correct, but don't like crease the paper, except right here. Okay, now our first real fold, we're going to be making a horizontal line that intersects that point throughout the entire paper. Okay.
Next, we are going to take this edge and fold it to the crease we just made and unfold. Okay, and same thing, take the edge and fold it to the crease we just made. Okay. Now we are going to make two vertical creases intersecting through the intersection of here and here. It's gonna look something like this. And one on the other side, right here. Just like that. Okay. Next, we are going to make a crease in the middle of this one and this one. So I'm going to inverse this crease, and I'm going to put it up against the other one, the center one. Or, well, not the center. It's actually not the center, but you know what I mean. Sorry guys, I'm using foil paper, not tissue foil. Tissue foil would be hard too, but I'm using foil paper, so it's hard for me to inverse creases quickly. All right, and we're gonna put it right to this crease. And crease down, there we go. I'm gonna lift this up and crease it a little better. Cool, so now we have this crease. Always make sure to like put the paper back in the correct orientation after every fold, or you'll forget. Okay, now we're gonna take this edge and fold it to here, creating a crease right there. Just like that. And finally, you guessed it, from here to here, one more crease. Alright, flip her over, make sure to keep the orientation the same, okay? Now, we're going to fold the corners into this point, and this point, and this point, but this top right one, only fold here, do not fold all the way across. So, let's do that one first, let's do the weird one first. So, only fold from the center down like that. Do not fold this part, just fold this part. For all the other ones, fold the whole thing. All last corner. Just like that. So this weird one is gonna be the top right. Don't lose track of this. Okay, now we're gonna make some more creases on this side. First, let's make the crease from here to here by folding this corner down like this. Corner to this point, fold, okay. And fold all the way across, if that wasn't implied. Okay. Now fold, let's do this one, from this point, you can see that, from this point just to here. So to do that, fold this corner to this point. But only crease to where this crease intersects the edge. Like that. And while we're at it, let's do the other fold. So we're going from the edge of the paper, like, so to make this next fold, we also do this, but we only crease it from the edge of the paper to this point right here, where this crease intersects the edge. Okay, so now we just made this crease, and we just made this crease. Finally, to finish the stuff off, let's make the crease from this point to this point, intersecting this, by folding this corner to right here. So again, do not fold all the way across, just fold to this crease intersection, and to this crease intersection, right here. So it's gonna look like that. All the while, just keeping the paper's orientation in mind. Do not, like, forget, because it's very easy to with this. Okay, now we're gonna be working from the other direction. Let's make a crease from here to the edge of the paper by folding this corner to this point in the center. These are not I'm not folding it to random points, by the way. I hope you see the references that I'm referencing. Okay, let's also make a fold from here to here by folding that corner to this point. So from this crease intersection to the edge of the paper. Okay, two more for this step. From here, right here, to the edge of the paper. So fold the corner to this point. And let's start this crease from the edge of the paper. And we're going to, I believe, this point right here. I'm not entirely sure. Yeah. Yep. Right there. All right, now that we have that last crease, we're going to make a crease from here to here. So bring the corner to this point and crease from the edge of the paper to this crease intersection right there. Just like that. Alright, done with that step. Let's flip it over again, keeping the orientation the same. So the one corner where we only did half, not the whole thing, that corner is now in the top left. Okay? Yes, that is correct. Alright, we've got three folds. Let's make a fold from here to here. A crease from here to here. So from this point to the edge. Alright, just like that. Now let's make a crease from this point to the edge. So let's see, from I believe this point to the edge of the paper. Yep. And finally, let's make a crease from edge to edge by folding this edge to the crease. Okay. Flip it over again. So now the half line is going to be on the top right. Got a lot more pre-creases. We're almost done with pre-creases, I promise. Two more steps. So first, let's make a crease from here to here. So... So from here to here, I believe. Yep. There to there. Okay. Now we need to make a crease. You know what? I'm going to get a pencil. I think I have one. Yeah. So you guys can see this. So from here to here. Now we're going to make one from... Let me flip this back around. From here to here. Let's do that. Okay, right to there. Perfect. Now we're going to make a crease from here to the edge of the paper. Like that. Now we're gonna make a crease from here to here. Just like that. And finally, we're going to make a crease from here to here. And here to here, so we can do this all at the same time. Alright, you know what? I'm gonna spin it around and do this. Alright, so let's see. From this crease to this crease. That's one of them, and then from this crease to that crease. There we go. Flip it back around in the correct orientation. Alright, and the final pre-creasing step. Hallelujah. We are going to fold from here to here. From here to here, from here, I believe. No. From here to the edge of the paper again. From here to here. There's a lot this step. From here to here. From here to here. And finally, from here to here. And I like how the dots are already there from the previous steps. Okay, let's do this. Let's start with this one. All right, there to there is done. Now let's do this one from here to here. Folded it a little off, so I'm gonna try to fix the crease. Just like that. And we're going to there, okay. So we just did from there to there. Now, let's go from here to the edge of the paper. Let's do these. So let's do this one first. And if you're not aware, I'm folding this edge to one of these lines. Because every single time, if I fold it to one of these lines, it works out. I'm not just like folding it randomly. Right? But ironically, for this specific case, Never mind. I thought there wasn't a line for this one, but there is. So all of these lines we're making, we're folding some place, we're folding something in half. So that's why I'm able to fold to lines that have already been made. Alright, so we just made there to there. Now let's make the crease from here to here. Just like that. And last one from here to there. Oops, I went too far. There we go. Pre-creasing done for now, probably. Okay, now for the real folding, guys. 23 minutes, holy shit. First step, flip her over. And again, this one, the half crease thing, top left. We got this. I'd highly recommend following the instructions that are linked along with my... Well, honestly, you don't really need the video to follow the pre-creasing, but I'm doing it anyway. Okay. So before we do this next step, let's make one more pre-crease. Two more, actually. One is going to be from here to here. Like this. Halfway, do not fold this all the way. You notice this is the first time we're actually folding the paper in half. Right to the center. And a second fold from here to here, only the opposite way. So like this. So from here, wait. Oh, shit. See, I've lost the orientation. All right, this half, the half triangle should be at the top left. So what did I just make? Oh my god, this is so confusing. All right. I'm pretty sure I just made this crease. So now I need to make this crease right here, going the going this way. All right, I got it. You gotta be careful. It's especially right now. It's like extremely easy to mess up the orientation. There we go. Make sure this is aligned correctly. From the center to the edge. Okay, now for the first real fold. Here we go, guys, the hype. Color side up. And we're gonna rabbit ear fold, so. Mountain fold this. Now unfold this. Now unfold this. And we're gonna use that valley fold to flatten it. Oops, like this. Okay. Just like that, guys. So, like that. Okay. Now we're gonna open sync in and out. Remember, open sync means you do all the layers. So we're gonna open sync here and here. And I don't know why they did this, but like, this line is missing. I don't know why we just didn't make that line, so. You'll see what I mean. So this right here is gonna be. I'm making it right now. So we still need to make a crease from here to the edge. There. All right. This one should be mountain folded, not the one I was doing. My bad. Yeah. It's very, very easy to lose the orientation in this model. Okay, and now that we've got the outside, let's do the inside. Just like that. Okay. So this is what the inside looks like. Now that that's done, we are going to fold this down. Fold this layer down. And we're gonna open sync both sides. So this, we're gonna open sync this, and we're gonna open sync this. So again, with foil paper, it is not easy to do this, but this is the technique you should use. In my opinion. Really make sure it's not that important that this right here, this crease, is perfectly vertical. But obviously, the more vertical it is, the better. Alright, so that's what you want to do. Let's do it to the other side now. Dare I say that went quite smooth. As far as open sinks go. Alright, there we go. Two open sinks. And you should get this. You will get this. And let's do some more open sinks. So, take this flap and fold it to the center. And close sink it. Not open sink it. We're going to close sink this. So that means we don't open these flaps. We just sink it how it is. And to be honest, closed sinks are... It depends, but some are harder, some are easier. This one is actually significantly easier than an open sink. So what you see me doing, I'm putting my hand in it and I'm just spreading it out. And then you do not open these flaps. You just, because it's a closed sink, you sink it with the flaps. You sink it with the flaps. There's a closed sink later on that's very, very hard to do, in my opinion. Much, much later on, but we'll get to it, and we'll do it. Alright, and you'll get this. Nice little... I can open it. Nice closed sink. Yep. Alright, cool. Next, we are going to fold this up like that. Okay, now we're going to do a pretty cool fold. We are going to petal fold, but not the center. So it's going to look something like this. Fold along this right here. We're going to use like all pre-creases. So this is folded up. Now, make sure mountain fold here and here. And also mountain fold the top, I think. Oh, no, take that back. Just don't touch the top, just let the top be. This isn't gonna lie flat. On the right and left sides, you see these creases, mountain fold them as well. And finally, we're gonna valley fold here and here. Okay, and we'll get this. And all you do is flatten it, and it flattens perfectly. Okay, just like that. Now valley fold this whole thing across. Be careful about this part, make sure you crease it well. Make sure you crease it cleanly. Okay, now fold this top flap along this crease. And simultaneously mountain folding along this crease. And you get a nice little squash fold right here. just like this. This should happen. This should not lie flat. Okay. Now, all you do is fold along this crease, like this, and fold along this crease, like this, and the whole thing will lie flat. So it's all pre-creases right now, guys. Okay. Now we're gonna flip her over and do the same thing that we just did. So, fold up. Squash fold. Now we get this thing. Fold it like this. And fold this down. Just like that. And you will get exactly this. All right, now reverse fold these two flaps along this crease. So this is kind of harder than it sounds. You have to open up the whole thing and push in, be careful. And fold along this crease and this crease. Like that. You get this. So from this to this. So let's do it to the other side. Just like that. Okay, cool. Take your time with that step. Don't rush it. All right. Now the fun begins. Zoom in a little. All right. So, hold on. Let me just really quickly mark where the camera sees. Okay. Okay, now I can sit down, because it's zoomed in, so I don't want to, like, be off camera. Okay. First, fold one layer over. Exactly one layer. Now, take this flap right here, and fold it to the center. Like that. Now, take this flap and fold it to the crease you just made. We're separating this thing in the fourths. We're separating this flap in the fourths. And finally, fold this crease to the center. Like along the center, yeah. Just like that. Now we are open sinking the whole thing, in and out. So, let's open this up. This crab does a lot of open sinking. All right, so we have this pyramid type thing. How I open sink, this at least. I start from the outside and work my way in. So first, let's mount and fold all the outside creases. Okay, now let's valley fold the inside creases that aren't already. Okay, now let's mount and fold the inside creases again. The inside. And then just collapse like that. And you will have succeeded. So this is exactly what you should get. This right here. If you found this step hard, that's okay. But if you weren't able to do this step, then just practice. If you can't do this, then you won't be able to make this crab. All right, next step. Fold this layer back. And repeat what we just did. So flip it over, fold one layer over, and fold this into fourths, and then open sink it in and out. Easy peasy. All right, and you'll get this. It's gonna look like this, little sailboat kind of thing. Okay, flip it back over, obviously, to this orientation. And now let's do the next step. Yeah, okay, just making sure. So take this top flap only, this very top flap, and fold this edge to this edge, creating an angle bisector. Sorry, I don't want to fold out of frame. All right, and you can guess what we're gonna do. Open sink. All day. So, that means open the flap and you sink the flap as well. So I'm gonna just open this whole thing. And we're open sinking this arrow type thing. So start with the outside. There we go. And now the inside. Oh wait, I gotta get this little corner. If creases are giving you trouble pulling on it, sometimes works. More so with regular paper than foil, but still with foil, if you like tug on it a little bit, it'll straighten out sometimes if you do it right. It takes a lot of touch. But anyway, that's what the open sink looks like, just like that. All right, now we are going to fold this flap down. Like that. Actually, I think I went too far. Yeah, I went too far, sorry. There, like that. Unfold, and now we are going to fold this whole thing down. And we're gonna spread sink, or spread squash rather. So open this up, inverse this fold you just made. Fold this like that. And it's gonna flatten like this. We have to flatten this part, so let's do that. How, you may ask? That is a good question. Open this point up. And we wanna we wanna squash it like this. So let's make this a little bit neater. How you do this will definitely vary depending on the type of paper you use. Like if you're using normal paper, this step will probably be nicer. Okay, let's get, okay, that's perfect. Well, perfect enough. An average origamist. Perfect enough. No, right. So now, you got this little flapper. We are going to take this point and fold it to the center. And unfold. And we now have to open sync it. So, fortunately, we have an easy way to get inside it, sort of. So we're gonna open sync this triangle right here. This is actually pretty easy. This is extremely easy. Compared to the open syncs we're gonna do soon. All right, and once you're done with that, reform the model. Make sure you reform this part correctly. Okay, and we're done with that. Folder back up. Okay. This flap. All the way over. Grease it nicely. To get this. And this should obviously be... you get this. It should not be pointed at the top. It should be straight line at the top. And we got this flapper right here. And I think you can guess what we're going to do with it. But if you did not guess, fold it into fourths. So fold it to here. And now split that fold up. So fold the top to the crease you just made. And fold the center crease to the bottom crease, the bottom edge. Unfold and open sync some more. Okay, this is, it's not that tough, but it's just gotta be careful about reassembling it once you're done. So let's open this puppy up very carefully. I try to make a mental note of how it is before you open it, so you can reassemble it after. Be very careful when you're opening this up. It doesn't completely open, but this is good enough. This is definitely good enough. So, let me reassemble it. I forgot which crease we start on. We're going to start on this one. Okay, so one from the edge. Yeah, that was obvious. Okay, once you have carefully opened it, start open syncing. So start from the outside. Open sync complete. Let's attempt to reassemble it how it was. You know what? Hold on. It was like... No. It was like this. It was like this. There we go. This part was facing up. And this was here. This is exactly how it was. Okay, cool. Awesome. So that is that open sync. That is not the hardest step. It's not even close to the hardest step of this. We're like one tenth of the way done. Maybe one fifth. Anyway, we're valley fold. Now we're just folding everything over, okay? Just the whole thing. Next step, valley fold one flap, repeat behind. So, valley fold this flap forward, like that. Repeat behind. So I assume they want us to do this because, yeah. Okay, now here is, I'd say, the third or second hardest step of the whole thing. So, okay, we're gonna mount and fold this crease. Mountain fold this crease. And valley fold this crease. Not gonna lay flat, not even close. You get this. You get exactly this. This little fan and this rectangle. Okay. Next, do this one time. Valley fold here, mountain fold here. And also, you're gonna have to do this. Punch, like, push this up. One layer. And valley fold right there. Okay, so now, and you also, you can push this down too. Now we have this. Okay. Unfold this area. Unfold this area like this. I'm not gonna zoom out. I don't have to zoom out. Okay, unfold this area like this. Now, there's a couple things we have to do. But first, see this fold, see this point? I'm gonna zoom out a little because I don't want you guys to miss anything. All right, this point, see, okay. So the crease going to that point, inverse it, mountain fold it. Those terms are not synonymous, just saying. Just be, and be really careful. All right, so this crease is mountain folded. This crease is mountain folded. Now you should see this crease mountain fold that as well. And from this crease, from this point over until, just from this point, you see this crease, mountain fold this crease, and we're gonna be able to push out the layers like this. Okay, and you keep mountain folding this crease up until this diagonal line, which continues up. Okay, this is not gonna lie flat yet. But this area is not pleated. Okay, so, oh, and mountain fold this diagonal as well. So we have this, right? Now we gotta work with this area, which is surprisingly easy. Next horizontal fold over, valley fold it. And also valley fold this diagonal, so it lays flat. And you valley fold it up to this diagonal, and we're gonna valley fold that diagonal as well. Now, the next one, the next horizontal fold, you mountain fold it. This is slightly tough. Like that. And mountain fold this diagonal. And finally, valley fold this area. And it just did it by itself because of the pre-creases. But that is that entire step. Bam. The second hardest step, possibly the first hardest step of this whole crab. In fact, this is the hardest step. The other step I'm talking about is only hard because the diagram is terrible. But it was actually pretty easy to fold. This was hard to fold and hard to understand from the diagram, but there it is. So that's step 53, by the way, and 52 and 51. anyway, so now we have this. So get it into this orientation. We're going to now reverse fold this crease. Okay, let me scroll down. And now we're swivel folding this crease and a couple other creases. So okay, before we make the swivel fold, I forgot a fold. Well, sort of. Make a crease from here to here. Now it'll work. So let's try that again. Just like that. Okay. Reverse fold this little triangle. And we're gonna do some more sinking. Yay. Alright, so we're gonna sink this fold and this fold. So let's just, I know there's already pre-creases, but let's crease them again. Just so we don't lose them. And we are, it does not clarify whether it's an open sink, so I'm gonna assume it is. So let's open this up. And we're sinking this whole area. So let's do that. Now putting this back together is kind of awkward because it's not completely obvious how it goes, but it should just fold into place like this. So maybe it is obvious. Never mind. So you get this. Now we're gonna reverse fold this little corner. Okay, now reverse fold along this line. Now there's a lot of paper. Make sure this what we're doing right now goes under all the flaps. Like that. Okay, now we're going to flip the model over and create angle bisectors using this pre-crease. So like this. And also fold this pre-crease to this line right here. Like this. I think. Yes. Oops. All right, just like that. So now we just made that crease and that crease. And we're gonna crimp. So let's do that using the creases we just made. So let's do the bigger one first. And now the middle one. Sorry. Okay, and finally, the smallest one. If I'm not mistaken, this is the big claw. All right, guys. Next step, we are going to fold this edge to the center to just reinforce the pre-crease we already have. All right, now we're going to open sink along this line. And there's going to be a squash. There's going to be a spread squash. So this is kind of a tough step. So this line. So let's work. So the spread squash is going to be here. So let's work on this area first. Where did that line go? All right. So inverse this crease. Inverse these, mount and fold these rather. So we're sinking, sorry, I was out of camera. We're sinking this area. And the spread squash is going to be here. Okay. Right? Wait, is that right? I know that the spread, that's probably not right. This step is not easy, I admit. Okay, the spread squash is here. Yeah, might be. This is correct, this right here. The spread squash is gonna occur right here. So to do it, let's flatten this and just slowly press down. There we go. That's the spread squash right there. Sorry, it just took me a little bit to figure it out, but I got it. I am definitely cutting out the part where I was confused. Anyway, and the rest of the open sink goes like this. Bam. All right, cool. So let's keep going. Fold this flap down. It's not gonna lay flat. And yeah, do not squash the left side. Just squash this side. So, okay, let's see if we can do this easily. If you pull on this and place your fingers like this, and then press down at the top sometimes, it should go smoothly. This is a tough one though, because it's right on the edge of an edge. Right on the edge of an edge. Wow. GG. Okay. There. So now let's just make the corners cleaner, like by again, slightly tugging it. Bam, perfect. I think we're folding. Nope, we're not done yet. The fun isn't over yet. Oh boy. We are gonna do a pretty intense open sink. First though, take this layer. Take this, the front layer, I'm quite sure. So this, not the back. Yeah, you're leaving the back. Do not touch this. This front, like this area, just folds to the center because we're gonna be open sinking it. Spoilers. Something like that. It's just like that, all right? Now we're gonna open sink it. So let's try to get inside here. Yep, you can get inside here like this. Okay. I'm sitting down for this one. So let's open this up. That's the first step of open sinking. Yeah, okay. The ends of this U are closed. But, so you see this flap? Can you see this flap? Yeah, this flap, do not touch this. We're just focusing on this. I'm trying to open it a little more. All right, I got it enough. So, you see this U that we just folded down? That's what we're open sinking. But there's flaps here and here where we close sink them. So just ignore them, basically. All right, so let's work with the base of the U first. Uh, This is a very hard step. So take your time. It's important not to lose your pre-creases, because if you can't find your pre-creases, it's not good. I just hope I don't lose mine. I'm working at it. I'm pretty close, to be honest. I know it doesn't look it, but maybe it looks it. I don't know. Yeah, that pre-crease is extremely important, so make sure you crease it well. Although, for most of you, it's probably too late. Alright, now hopefully, yep, and it just goes back like this. Make sure the inside is as clean as possible. It's okay if it's not perfect though. Alright, that is pretty dang good. Let's see if I can just clean up this area though. There we go. So, now that that's done, this is still here. Do not sink this, that would be bad. But do sink this you. I did not sink this area enough. In my opinion. Alright, that's a little better. Okay, cool. So, that is that. Not an easy fold. Take your time with that. Alright, fold this flap back up. Next step, we are going to valley fold this thing over. I don't know what happened with this little guy. Hold on. What's going on there? There we go. Okay. It should look like this. Great, some more sinking. Take this flat, fold it to the center. Paper just ripped. I'm very, very, you know what? I'm taping this. Origami at its finest. There. It's like it was never ripped. Okay. Continuing. Sorry. Folding this flap to the center. So. And close sink it. Okay? Close sink it. So there are flaps. Sort of. Just ignore them. We've made this close thing before. It's pretty easy. Okay. There we go. Very nice. Okay, this next step sucks so hard. It's terrible. So I'm gonna cut this, to be completely honest. We have to. Okay, so first though, make sure that this little flap and this little flap are pushed over like this. Don't forget them. We have to spread sync all these tips. So I'm gonna do one, but there are 12 of them. So I'm gonna do a hard one on camera. So let's look at this one right here. You have to do this 12 separate times, but all you do is fold this corner to the center. Like that, and unfold. And now you have to spread sync it. So this one, you can't get inside. Like, you can't get your finger inside of it. So what you have to do is spread the layers like this and just gently press it down. Like that. And I made it look quite easy, to be completely honest. And because I've done it 12 times. Actually, 16 times-ish. So, for the last crab. But that's what you need to do for all these flaps. So all the flaps should look like this. So you do it on this flap, this flap, this flap. That's 3. I've already done 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You have to do it 12 times. So I'll be right back.
Alright guys, and we are back. All 12 flaps have been open synced, so let's continue. The next step, valley fold this whole thing over to the right. I'm zoomed in, so let's sit down.
Alright. We are going to now open sync the top. So let's open this thing up. This is a pretty easy fold. All things considered.
Good enough. All right. Now, open it and flatten it like this. All right. These next couple folds, they're easy to do, but the diagrams are very hard to understand, in my opinion. So, and they're kind of incomplete. So this next fold. First, this is not in the instructions, but we need to make some pre-creases. Fold these two flaps, this top edge thing, right, like down like this, creating an angle bisector. Just like that. Okay, and now, fold this edge against this, like this. And fold all the way to the center line, and do the same for the other side. You can't really just fold it as far as you can. These are just pre-creases. Don't really stress if you can't when you aren't able to fold like all the way. But okay, so this next fold is kind of weird. We are going to open this whole thing up. Just get your finger in there. Okay. Well, not yet, I guess. These two folds, we're going to mount and fold. Oops. We're going to mount and fold them. This top fold, we're going to flatten, and we're going to valley fold these two lines. So that'll look something like this. I can get in there. There we go. So flatten the top. And valley fold along these. So that was pretty easy, but the diagrams the diagrams make it, they don't tell you to do any pre-creases, and
yeah.
Anyway, this is exactly what you should get. The top should look like this. And now we do to this side. So, you'll get this. Alright, so next step, flip the bottle over. And we will get this. Valley fold this flap down. It's not gonna lie flat. Fold this flap. Okay, fold these flaps over. Okay. And now we are going to fold this in the forts and open sink in and out again. And we are good, just like that. Bam. All right, so now, let's do the same thing we, okay, so you have this, possibly. Make sure this flap, make sure there's one flap on the right side. So it should look like this. So, okay, now we're gonna do the same thing we did before with the open sinking. So fold it down like this. And spread sink it. So spread sink this one, and this one. So there we go. Good enough. Valley fold this tip back over. Fold this back up. It'll lay flat now. Valley fold this whole section, I think. Yeah. This whole section. Like right here. And these flaps are gonna lay like that. Oops. There we go. Like this, okay. Doing that off camera, kind of. Sorry about that. Okay, now we're going to valley fold this tip. How many tips, you ask? I'm not sure. I'm thinking just the first one. Yeah, just the top one. So only valley fold the top one. Now fold this flap up. This whole thing. Okay. And fold it back over. Fold all of it back over, yeah. So now you're gonna have all of the flaps for the legs on this side. Now we're gonna flip it over and, wait, what? Hold on. Repeat on the left side. Not flip it over. Don't flip it over. Repeat that on this side. So we're gonna flip this flap. Flip the flap. over. Fold this up. Like that. Fold this back over like that. There we go. Okay, cool. Now we're gonna start messing with these guys. This is fun. It's not that bad, but. So let's make some angle bisectors. Take the top flap, take the very top flap, and fold it to this crease right here. And now take this crease and fold it to this edge. Like that. Now we're gonna crimp in and out. So
Let's crimp using the creases we just made. Now this one. Like that. Oh, you know what? Nope, we do this one. The diagram makes it a little bit unclear, but okay. Just misunderstood it the first time I did this. Okay. All right, fold the layers up, including the water on base. So fold the layers up like this. So I believe they're talking, this is the water on base. So we're folding all, like, this up and this up. Okay. So we get this. So we'll fold, okay. So now we're gonna take this, top flap and open this up. And we're going to swivel fold the whole thing in like this. God damn it. Foil paper. All right, there. And I believe, yeah, a triangle gets made here. There we go. Okay. So again, we just swivel folded this thing inside. And we also, this wasn't here before, and we made that. All right. That was fun. So we've got this, right? We've got this. Now let's create an angle bisector here. Here. Right there, if you can see that. Hopefully. I don't know what's going on with that paper, but whatever. So right there, and then unfold. And we want a closed sink. Now this was the closed sink I was talking about that was very, very tough. So you see this flap here? You see this flap here? We do not want to sink that flap. We want to pretend like that flap isn't there. So to do that, we need to open up the paper. Get your finger in there and, okay. And just try to keep the flap, this flap, from opening up, which is very, very tough. But okay, here we go. So now we need to open sink this diamond area, the area that we just folded, without this flap coming undone, which is pretty much impossible. So let's do it. Yeah, it is. I don't like this fold. I'm just gonna do this. Once again, screw foil paper. Wow, okay. I mean, that's ugly. Oh, I see the fold, but I can't make it because of foil. There, I got it. Okay. That went a lot better than the first time I did it with my first one, I have to admit. Wow. Yeah, but anyway, that's that fold. It's not easy. Although I might have made it look easy. I'm not sure. I don't know. But anyway, so if you did it right, this should be locked. This should not be able to, like, open there. So, and I did do it right, believe it or not. Well, right enough. I did it correctly enough. All right. Next step, close the layers. Oh, and we open sync some more. Oh, boy. Okay. So we need to open sync this paper. We need to open sync this paper, but not this. So let's fold it first. This is what we're open sinking. Along that crease I just made, except this paper right here. So let me open this up and show you what I mean. Basically, we're open sinking this, but not this. So let's do that. Hopefully. Alright, cool. So, just like that. See how this paper right here is now sunk, but this stuff isn't? That's perfect. Next step, we're going to ignore this stuff for now and just focus on this flap. So let's fold this edge to the horizontal. And make the angle bisectors again. One there and one here. This is slightly awkward to fold. This is really awkward to fold. Actually, you know what? You can do it the other way. Because you know it's just going to be going along. This next fold is going to be going along with these. So. You can just fold it like this. And I assume we're gonna be crimping them. So let's do that. Let's crimp a Rooney. All right, there's one. There's two. And one more. Oh, it looks like... Did I fold that one? No, this one's... It's not low enough, so let's make it low enough. There. Perfect. Alright, just like that. Now we're gonna open sync again. What we're gonna open sync is kind of weird. Step 108. Okay, I have a feeling this should. Okay, my thing was like this. I'm pretty sure it should be like this. Based on the diagrams, it should be. Yeah, it should be like this. All right, I figured it out. Sorry. Okay, so you see this thing? We're gonna make a pre-crease. Which is, we're gonna take this edge and fold it to the center. And this is what we're open sinking. Okay, that crease right there is what we're open sinking. But we also are sinking this right here. So make this crease. We're also sinking that. So now when we open it up, yeah, that's right. It's gonna look like this triangle type thing. So we're gonna open sync this, the thing we just folded, and then we keep going around. there. So now when we close it up, yeah, that's perfect. Now when you close it up, well, the paper's gone because we opened Zunk it. And as well as this stuff. So that's perfect, I hope. all right, let's keep going. Okay. So we're here, we have this. Flip the model over. Now we're gonna valley fold this whole thing like this. Okay. Now we're gonna do the same thing as we did, like, to make this paper. So we're gonna do the same thing here. How much are we holding up? So kind of fold it kind of like this. So this thing right here, we're gonna do the same thing as we did here. And the creases for these guys, just like this. Okay. Should be like this. I don't know if you guys can see this, but I did it the wrong way. But it's, you probably caught my mistake. And if you didn't, sorry. Pre-crease should be this way. There we go. Okay. Now we can make this fold. If I can unfold it. All right. So get your finger up in there. So mountain fold these. Flatten this one out. Bring the paper out like that using your other two folds. And voila, we've got this. Oh, okay. All right, so guys, I figured it out, sorry. So, we have this, okay? We wanna take this point, this tip right here, and put it here by folding against this crease, and, no, sorry. This point is the lower one. This is the center point. So we wanna kinda fold along this crease and this crease, like this. Okay, so we have this. This is easy, but flattening this area is not. Well, at least for me, it wasn't. So, just try to do what I do. I'm not entirely sure if this is what they wanted me to do, but this is how I could flatten it. And the diagramming is telling me almost nothing. So for me, that works. This is the inside. This looks right to me, to be completely honest. So we get this, right? And that wasn't even the hardest step. Actually, this next step is at least for me, it was not easy, but I'm pretty sure after doing it once, I'll be able to do it again. So, okay, for this next step, we should be here. So we are going to make, let's make this fold first. So fold this up a little bit. Fold this whole strip up. Okay? So we have this. And it kind of makes this thing want to rotate, and that's what we want. We want this thing to rotate. So we need to make two more folds to allow it to rotate. We're here. Okay? We're here. We want to fold this up, which rotates this. And
we want to make a crease. We want to make a crease, a vertical crease here, behind here, and a diagonal crease here. So if you put your finger here and your other hand here and just rotate like this, putting this stuff down, putting this stuff against this line, so like that. Like that. You'll end up with what you're supposed to. That is the best way I can describe it. I'm not sure how, you know what, this looks better than how it was. There, okay, I like this. That's how you do it.
Flip it over. Okay, so yeah, this stuff should be up right here. That's okay. At least some of it should. I don't know how much of it should be, but we'll see. Anyway, so we're gonna open sync, I believe, this layer right here. We wanna close sync this area really quick. It should look like this. So these two back flaps should be here, and this front flap should be like this, which allows you to fold down this front flap without interfering with these back flaps. But so when you're supposed to close sync this, but I'm not able to get to it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna fold it down like that and pretend it's close synced. So let's keep going. Okay, next we're gonna do a swivel fold. So this is pretty easy. It wants us to fold this flap back like this. Yeah. But to do that, you also have to fold this flap like this. All the way to this point. You get this. So you're also making a crease right there. Okay? Next, we're going to reverse fold. We're going to reverse fold this. So take this flap, fold it in like this. Try your best to make it flat. Alright, it should look something like that. Yeah, I'm quite positive that's correct. Okay. Now we're gonna reverse fold this flap right here, so that's easy. That. Now flip over the model. Look at this. So we're gonna look at this first flap now. And yeah. Fold the first flap down like this. And close sync. So let's do that. So because it's a close sync, we do not open it up. We pretend there are no flaps and we just sync it. Although in this position, it's very hard to do so. That's the best I can do. Which honestly isn't that bad. Alright, and now we're gonna do another close sync on this back layer. So fold that down and open it up. close sync it. All right, like that, cool. Don't know what's going on there, but, oh, I know. It's my closed sync turning into an open sync. That's okay. It's all good. All right, there we go. So this is the small claw, by the way. Now we're gonna be working on the big claw. So let's fold this part over like this. Just to shape the claw a bit. Maybe a little more. Yeah, like that. Something like that. There we go. Perfect. Perfect. Alright. Now rotate the model. Alright, now we're gonna be forming the body. So okay. So we're going to mount and fold here. Mount and fold here. And make a pleat around this area, and this is going to make the body three-dimensional. This part is going to be 3D, and it's not going to lay flat. And let's do the same thing to this side. So it doesn't really matter what you do, but whatever you do, make sure you do it to the other side as well, like exactly the same. Okay, so you should have something like this. And now let's fold this big flap under from this edge and the other edge. Now we're gonna start shaping the legs and the claws. Looks like we're working on the claws first though. So first, let's look at the big one. We're going to make a rabbit ear fold with this crease. So we're gonna make a crease around here to around this point, okay? And we are going to now rabbit ear fold. So make, like, press here with your thumb, make a little triangle. See this triangle, and fold under like that. And that's your rabbit ear fold. The paper is very thick here, so do your best. Okay. And now let's make two crimps to shape the claw. And I believe you should be crimping where you made the rabbit ear fold. So let's do that. Make it a little farther away. There's one crimp. And two crimps. There we go. That looks really good. Okay. We're not done with it, but we're done with it now. For now. Now let's shape the small claw. So we're going to mount and fold here, right down the center. And again, put your thumb here, make a little triangle, fold under. That's your rabbit ear fold. Now this little guy, you know what, it should have room for two crimps. There we go, second crimp right there. All right, GG. Okay, those are the claws. Let's do the legs now. All right. So, next step, it literally just says separate the legs with a bunch of arrows. So, that's helpful. What I do, I make the two legs that are, like, interlocked like this, I make those the front two. So, the one on the outside, that's the very front. Now, for the second leg, there we go. I think, yeah, I'm gonna have to crimp it like this. Okay. Or pleat it or whatever. Okay, there. That's the second leg. Now, the third and fourth leg. I'm gonna make this the third leg by folding it like that. And this the fourth leg. By folding it like that. So you get this nice spread of legs. Get the nice crab legs, okay? Alright, let's do it to the other side now. Move this leg and fold it there. Alright, so we've got our crab legs. Awesome. Now we're just gonna do a bunch of shaping. So pinch and shape the legs. That is what the step says. So let's do that. Working with the front one first. Honestly, just fold it in half. Just fold it in half like this. For the two that are interlocking, you can't go all the way, but that's okay. There, just go as far as you can like that. So we're not gonna. Fold it in half. Like this, and make it so you'll be able to pleat it down like this. Right? Like that. So that's what the legs are gonna do. We're just setting up for that. So fold it in half. As far as you can, and just leave it for now. So again, fold it in half. And fold it in half. Awesome. There's some fine looking crab legs. Okay. Do the same thing to the other side. Alright, the other side is done. Alright, now we're going to be focusing on the head. Okay. So, let's look at the eyes first. You're going to see four flaps. Right? I think. Where's this flap? Oh, there. Okay. Yeah. Disappeared. Okay, so these two flaps are the eyes. So rabbit ear, let's make them. Rabbit ear fold them and fold them out. Like this. Let's do it again. Okay. Now, fold them up. And you're supposed to, like, make a little, like, ball at the top, but I can't. So I'm just gonna fold them out like this. And that looks pretty good to me. For the eyes. Now it wants us to shape this part, which isn't gonna happen, but I'm gonna try, I guess. Like, indent here, I guess. Like that. Sure. flip it over. This step's really important, guys. This step is very important. So you'll notice that, like, the legs all stem off of this area and this area. We're going to pleat that so the legs are closer in. And the claws. So, let's pleat it. This is start the pleat at the center. like this, and pleat it back about a quarter inch. Just like that. That's perfect. Look at that. So now the legs aren't like crazy out. They're under it. So let's do it again. The side with the small claw is going to be a little bit tougher to do because of this area, but you'll be able to make it work from some maneuvering of this area. But the bottom should look like this now instead of straight across like it was. Now we're going to do the detail in the mouth. So fold the flaps down. We're going to make both at the same time. Fold the flaps down. Swivel fold some paper out, so like this. So open this up. Now it's kind of like a squash fold, to be honest. And just like that. So you'll get some paper there that wasn't there before. And let's do the same thing to the other side. There we go. You guys can see this. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. Okay, so we've got some paper there that wasn't there before. Now fold, let's do this side first. Fold like this, over. Now fold across. Now just rabbit ear fold. Down and then just fold it out like that. So let's do that again on the other side. There we go. Just like that. So you'll get the two little whiskers, and that's basically the mouth. Alright guys, and for the last two steps we are gonna shape the claws and shape the legs, and then we are completely done. So let's shape the claws. First, let's make a crimp on the bottom two claws. So let's do the big one first. This is the bottom of the big claw. Let's make a crimp to separate them, basically. A small crimp of $1 million. Okay. There we go. Now, what I like to do personally, I don't know what they want me to do, but I like doing this. So I like to open it up and then fold each side in half. Okay, and what you get is like, sorry, I'm off camera. It's something like this. See that like 3D effect, and it's like sharp. All right, let me do it to the top one too. So again, I like to open it up, then fold it in half towards the center, like this. It gives it a nice 3D effect, and it makes it like look kind of like a real crab hand, to be honest. Okay, so that's the big claw. Big claw's done. Now the small claw. I'm just gonna separate them. They're too small. Actually, now here. Make a crimp. And sort of the same thing, only it's too small, so I'm just gonna rabbit ear fold them. Like this. And like this. Right, and that's the small claw. And finally, the legs. The legs are literally just two pleats for each one. So I'll show you a couple. And then I'm going to cut. So you want to open it up. You want to open the leg up. And just fold it like this. Fold the end where you want the leg to be, and then flatten the rest of it. And just pleat it. I don't know why I'm showing you guys how to pleat it. You pleat the leg. Alright guys, and we're back after we're doing the legs and messing around with them a bit. We're done.
We're completely done. This is the Fiddler Crab. This bottle is awesome. Like, it's amazing. The asymmetry just looks so good. So let's take a look. Let me zoom out there. So, as you can see, the legs all touch the ground, or at least they all should touch the ground. One tip I have, try to make the front legs lower than the back legs, or, because if you make them all even, it'll end up like tilting forward. So you need to make the front legs a little bit lower, like down towards, yeah, just lower. So then when the weight of the front, so the weight of the front doesn't like affect it. But anyway, we're done. You have made yourself a Fiddler Crab. All right, guys. I'll see you later. Thanks for watching.